Hello, my name is John. I'm a solution engineer at Surfly, and I'm going to walk you through how you can start a co-browsing journey or any kind of Surfly session from an existing customer chat conversation. So first, I'm going to give a quick demo walkthrough where I will start a conversation as the customer and then show you the different ways that you can respond as an agent. I won't go into the full co-browsing flow here in the interest of time, but I'll show you how they can be instigated by the customer and responded to by the agent. In this case, I'll be using Zendesk and a grab of the Apple webpage that I've made. I can only show one flow at a time, but Surfly offers several options when it comes to the experience of both the customer and the agent. So after the demo, I will go through some of the different options available from the customer side of things. Next, we'll talk about how this can be responded to from the agent side. So agent experience is also very important, and we'll have a look at the main options available when it comes to your agents and their own experience. Finally, I will explain how simple it is to implement a flow like this in your own systems. So whether you're using your own chat provider, whether you're using a vendor that we don't have a pre-built integration for or one that we do, it doesn't matter. Any flow that you see in this video, you will be able to implement without much difficulty. So let's get started with the demo. So on the left on the screen here, we have the Zendesk environment. This is our agent view. And on the right, we have a customer who is browsing a grab from the Apple website. So as the customer, perhaps I want some help buying my iPhone. So I click chat and I start a conversation with the agent. The agent can then respond to this request. And then after some time, we decide that it will be better if we just browse the website together. So as the agent now, I have a few options. I can instruct the customer to enter a text command. I could ask them to click on a pre-installed Surfly widget that can be installed from a snippet, which I'll show you shortly. Or I can, I've enabled a custom button on my website, and I will instruct the customer to click on wherever I've put that. So in this instance, I'll say to the customer, hey, scroll down until you find the Get Help Buying section, and then click Browse with an Apple Genius. So the customer does this, and they're then presented with a PIN code. And as the agent, I now have a couple of options. So here I've embedded a couple of views into the Zendesk environment through an iframe. The agent sees the incoming interaction. So I can click take call and the session will begin straight away. And secondly, we have the start session URL box. I could enter the PIN here as the agent and the session will begin. I can also go to the incoming queue screen where I can see the incoming call and take the call from there. So in the demo, the customer instigated the co-browsing session using a button that I added to the Apple webpage. But let's take a look at the different options you have when offering your customers a way to trigger a Surfly session. So first up, we have instigating via the chat widget in a text command. So once this text is submitted and it's caret Surfly, once it's submitted, it will immediately instigate a co-browsing session and the PIN will appear in the way that you just saw. It's important to note that the caret Surfly command can also be entered by the agent, so either side can do this. Once it's been entered into the chat, the PIN flow will begin. But what if maybe you would prefer not to have any kind of text command? Maybe you would just want the customer to click a button. And maybe you even want to restyle the pop-up and the PIN with your own branding. And you can do this as well with the custom implementation. So on the screen now, we can see a real implementation from one of our customers. They've added a small eye icon to the bottom of their page. So when their chat is used and they want to escalate to co-browsing, their agents will instruct the customer to click on this button and instigate a similar flow to the one that you just saw. With custom buttons, you can add your own branding. So the pop-up and the pin and everything can look different and match your in-house style. Perhaps you could even hide this button until the customer's been on the page for X amount of time or whatever other parameters you might want to use. You might notice that this customer has actually added an extra step to the flow as well, where they ask the visitor if they are sure they want to begin a co-browsing session. So custom implementations offer you the flexibility to add and remove steps as you see fit. So although it's very easy to add these custom buttons, it does require some web development. And what if you maybe you don't have these resources, or maybe you just want a simple button that you can quickly add to the page and get started from there? So we can do this as well. And I can show you how easy it is quickly now. So if I go to Wikipedia here, this is the regular Wikipedia website. In the Surfly environment, if you go to settings and integrations, you'll find a code snippet. This snippet, once added to a web page, produces a Get Help button widget, which will instigate the flow as you saw. It's very easy to install. It just needs to be added to the page code. So if I quickly add this to the console in Wikipedia, Simple as that, we now have this Get Live Help button down here. So if I click that, we can see that the PIN code has appeared. And if I now go to the queue, we can see the interaction coming from the Wikipedia main page as well. So next up, instigating via the Serfly widget. So this flow is simple, easy, requires minimal changes to your code. While it isn't as customizable as a custom button, the widget will still pull its colors from your Serfly settings so the look and feel can be in line with your branding without the extra work. So we have a few options for the customer, but what about the agent? We know the customer through some method of implementation. One of the ones I've just shown has instigated a session has been displayed a PIN code. So it makes sense then to start with the PIN flow. So option one for the agent, as I did in the demo, the agent can receive this PIN from the customer and paste it into the Serfly start session URL box. Once this is done, the agent will immediately join the customer on their page and start co-browsing. Because this PIN code is a simple four-digit key, this is a good flow for call escalations as well, because communicating four numbers isn't particularly hard on the phone. And as I mentioned before, Serfly's embed API enables you to embed this URL box into your own customer service portal, so the agent never needs to navigate away from the space they are familiar with. But you don't have to use the PIN. Next up, we have agent queue. So a PIN code is not the only way for an agent to respond to a request. It's possible to remove the PIN code step entirely if you like, and instead display maybe a message that says an agent will be available soon. So the agent will see this request in the queue, and along with any metadata that you've collected, and they can respond from there. Once they click take the call, they go straight into a session in much the same way. So the incoming queue page, much like the URL box, can be embedded into your portal using the Serfly embed API. So again, there's no need for agents to navigate anywhere else if you don't want them to. So there we have a few ways for the customer to join and a few ways for the agent to respond. Once we've decided on a flow, we need to set it up. So let's have a look at implementation. Serfly has a lot to offer out of the box, but also supports rich APIs that will enable you to make the journey you want regardless of your provider. So but let's begin with looking at the pre-built integrations. So for Intercom, Zendesk, OLog, and LiveChat, Serfly has a pre-built integration ready to go. You simply need to enable the settings as I'm doing on screen here. And once this is done, entering the caret Serfly command on your widget or on any web page with the Serfly code will immediately begin a session. To make sure the chat widget remains visible above the Serfly co-browse session, you will also need to make some small CSS changes to the widget. It's simple and easy, but please reach out if you need help with this and we'll be happy to assist. We can also assist you in implementing this flow for any chat provider. That is certainly not limited to the pre-built integrations that you see listed here. So when I say pre-built integration, I'm referring specifically to the caret Serfly method of starting this flow. If you plan to use a button either on the page or maybe even in the widget itself, no integration in the technical sense is actually needed between the chat provider that you have and Serfly. You just need to add the start session button to your page in some form. This is the one that instigates the PIN flow, and then edit the display settings of your widget so it remains on top. The widget can then be used to agree to a co-browsing session, communicate the PIN, and that's it. If you want to make the journey more advanced, add more steps, change the branding, whatever you want to do, you can use our JavaScript API, which I'll link towards at the end. If you want a very simple journey, something a little easier to implement, you can achieve this quickly and easily with any chat provider using our widget code snippet as well. So for a quick recap, Serfly can easily integrate into your existing flow and enhance the customer service experience by adding to the journey you already have. The customer can start the session in any way you want them to. The agent can respond to this call through the PIN or through the queue. They can do this in the Serfly standalone app, or they can do it through an embedded iframe in the portal that you're already using. The entire journey can be customized and is branded as much or as little as you like. And configuring the chat widget is simple and easy and will allow you to add a strong interactive element to any journey that you have. So thank you very much. If you'd like to learn more about implementing the chat escalation functionality, please visit help.serfly.com, follow the path on screen. If you'd like more information about the capabilities of our JavaScript API to build your own more developed journey, please go to docs.serfly.com, follow the path below to see what's possible. And for any questions that you want to ask directly, please send your queries to sales@serfly.com and we will be happy to answer them. So thank you and have a nice day.